Let's draw the Lewis structure for H2SO4. This is sulfuric acid. The first thing we do with Lewis structures, we count up the total number of valence electrons, and we use the periodic table to help us do that. So on the periodic table, we find hydrogen right here in group 1. That is one valence electron. We have two hydrogen atoms. Sulfur over here, that's in group 16, sometimes called 6A. Well, these have 6 valence electrons. And oxygen right above sulfur, it has 6 valence electrons, 4 oxygen atoms. So when we do the math here, we end up with 32 total valence electrons for the H2SO4 Lewis structure. So we'll put the least electronegative atom in the center, and note hydrogens will always go on the outside. So sulfur is the least electronegative. We'll put that in the center with 4 oxygen atoms. And then the hydrogens, they're going to go on the outside. So let's just put one here and then down here. So now we can put 2 electrons between atoms, and that's going to form the chemical bond. So we'll put 2 between each sulfur and oxygen. So we have these shared as a covalent bond, and now between the oxygen and the hydrogens. So we have our chemical bonds. At this point, we'll complete the octets on the outside atoms. So at this point, each hydrogen has 2 of these valence electrons. That's all it needs for a full highest energy level. The oxygens, each one of those has 8, and the sulfur in the middle, it has 8. And we've used all 32 valence electrons. So this looks like a pretty good Lewis structure for H2SO4, sulfuric acid. But with sulfur, sulfur is kind of strange. It can have more than 8 valence electrons. It can have an expanded octet. So we should always check the formal charges for sulfur. When we do that, we find that the oxygens with the single bond, they have a formal charge of -1, the sulfur has a formal charge of +2, and then these oxygens with the hydrogens on the end, they have a formal charge of 0. With Lewis structures, we want the formal charges to be as close to 0 as possible for each atom. If you need help calculating formal charges, there's a link at the end of this video. So what we can do here is if we move these electrons here between the oxygens and the sulfurs, that changes our formal charges so that everything is 0. Each oxygen still has 8 valence electrons. The sulfur, it has 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, but that's okay. Sulfur can have more than 8. It can have an expanded octet. So this really is the best Lewis structure for H2SO4, where we have the 2 double bonds on the oxygens. The sulfur, it has 12 total valence electrons. So that's the Lewis structure for H2SO4. If you need help with the molecular geometry, there's a link at the end of this video. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.